The word for Monday, January the 31st, 2011. The word is knack. Knack. K-N-A-C-K. How do I select these? I have a spreadsheet because people have asked. So I'll explain it. I have a spreadsheet of words. And I continue to add to them. And when I add, I resort them. They are sorted alphabetically. And I just randomly pick a number. And I go to that row, and there it is. Today, the number was 43. And that landed on the word knack. Of course, my first thought, being a music buff that I am, I thought about the knack. You're likely too young to remember the knack, but you do know the song. The knack was, how would you describe the knack? I guess they would have been described as a new wave, kind of a band. They were a West Coast band. The knack. This is the late 70s, early 80s. I'm guessing. Well, I'm not guessing, but I'm trying to remember. The knack. The big song was My Sharona. I had the record. I confess, I had the record. The knack. I don't know if they're still around or not. But that's not the meaning. Knack. K-N-A-C-K. I like the word. I've always liked the word. There's some words I just like the look. I like the look of the word, or I like the sound of the word. I like the look and the sound of knack. When I think of knack, I think of some special skill, some ability, some talent, maybe some know-how. You know, we'll talk about somebody, and, well, they've just got a knack. They've just got a knack for something. And usually it's, I don't know. I mean, I'm thinking, why do we use that word as opposed to skill or whatever? More often than not, in my experience, when we ascribe the word knack to somebody about some particular thing that they can do, it more often than not, I think, is some subtle something or other. Something, you know, well, I started to say something you may not can quite put your finger on, but that's not right. You know, I heard somebody the other day talking about another person and saying, you know, he's got a knack for reading people. And it's kind of that stuff. It's like, well, okay, what constitutes that knack? What constitutes that skill? What is it that he knows? When you say that he's able to read people, what exactly is that? And I that may be a component of knack or knackery. Is there such a thing? Is there such a word as knackery? Probably not. Doesn't sound right. So a person could have a knack to read people. A person could have a knack to do any number of things that are just kind of hard to quantify, kind of hard to explain. I'm not sure if we've all got a knack or not. Probably we do. And like most things, and like most of these words that I have recorded these things about, I tend to think of it in a positive way. It's not that I'm this wide-eyed optimist looking through rose-colored glasses, but, you know, a person that's got a knack to read people, that's an attribute. Who wouldn't want that? Who wouldn't want that knack? I'm trying to think if I've ever heard anybody use it. I'm sure I have. There were kids in the neighborhood, and they always had a knack for getting in trouble. You know, he's just got a knack for getting caught. He just has a... So, yeah, I have heard it. I have heard it in that vein. A knack for getting speeding tickets. I've heard that. Yeah, you know, man, when he drives, he's just got a knack for getting caught speeding. Yeah, I don't want that knack. I've had bouts where I've had spurts of my life where I had that knack. I don't have that knack anymore, thankfully. You don't want a knack for bad luck. You don't want a knack for getting in trouble. You don't want a knack for making bad choices, bad decisions. You want to make sure that whatever you have a knack for, make it something worthwhile. I've got a book somewhere, and I usually, when words come to mind, some book leaps to my mind. There is a book, and it escapes me. I'll put it in the show notes. Somebody has written a business book about knack. Knack's in the title, and you don't run across that very often. And in fact, I can tell you who it is. I can't remember his name, but I can tell you he's a columnist. Well, I say he has a column. I think he has a column in Inc. magazine. A business guy, and he wrote a book, and it's got Knack in the title of it, and it plumb evaded me. I don't know what I have a knack for. I would rather hope that I have a number of knacks. I would guess that you hope you have a number of knacks. Those things that we're able to do that are hard to explain, I guess. Hard to quantify. Maybe in some way kind of hard to put your finger on. Not in that, okay, the person who has a knack to read people, well, you can put your finger on that, but what you can't do is you can't put your finger on exactly why. Exactly what is it that he does? What constitutes that knack? And I think that's one thing that might make it different than, say, a skill or a talent. A person, you know, he's got a talent for public speaking. Well, we know what that means. That means he's able to articulate. He's able to speak in ways that engage the audience. He's not overly nervous, at least to the degree that it would prevent him from being effective on a platform or on a stage. And so we can put our finger on the components that make up a person's talent or skill to be a public speaker. But the person who has a knack for reading people, you could say, well, okay, I mean, is he an expert at body language and reading body language? Well, I don't know. He's just able to size up people. He just has a knack for sizing people up. And we know what we mean when we communicate it, but I think it's just kind of hard to, it's hard to quantify all of the skill sets that make that up. We recognize that he does have it. It's just all the little nuances and all the little subtleties that make up that knack. Those are hard. That's the hard part, maybe, of a knack. I don't know. Go Google knack and Google My Sharona. You can listen to My Sharona. My Sharona. See you tomorrow.